There is no doubt that every business needs a website, no matter what you sell. And even if people are finding you on social media, eventually they're going to want to come to your website to find out more information about you. A good website could be making you thousands or even millions of dollars, but a bad website could be turning customers off and costing you a lot in sales. As a business owner, you absolutely have to get your website right. Hi, my name is Halima and I am the founder of The Floral Guru, and today I'm going to be sharing with you 7 big mistakes that people make when building their website. And there's going to be a lot of information in this video, but not to worry, I've put together a nice handy PDF guide that summarizes everything that I'm going to talk through. It's free, you just have to click the link in the description box. The first mistake that a lot of people make is that they're not thinking of their website like the customer. When people come to your website, they are looking for answers, and you have just a few seconds to capture their attention before they click away. So how do you capture their attention right away? You have to answer 3 critical questions right up front. The first one is, what do you sell? The second one is, why should that matter? How is it going to make their life better? And the third one is, how do they do business with you? These are the 3 most important questions that your customer needs to understand before they even start digging further. So you have to answer them right up front. To help illustrate this example, I'm going to quickly show you the website for my business, thefloralguru.com. Right up front, when you get to our homepage, you see we have the answers to these 3 questions. We tell you what we provide, flowers and decor, why that matters or how that's going to make your life better by giving you your dream event, and what you need to do to get in contact with us. Request a consultation. It is very clear on our website, the answers to those 3 questions. You'll also see here that all of the sentences we have up front are pretty short, which leads me to mistake number 2, having too much text. What you have to realize is that people are not reading your website. They are just scanning it and looking for relevant information. And so when they see short, concise sentences, they are much more likely to read it versus long, drawn out paragraphs. So you want to keep it short as much as possible. If you're struggling with too much text on your website, ask yourself 2 questions. The first one is this important to my customer? And the second one is there a simpler way to say this? With the first question, is this important to my customer? You have to be really honest with yourself. That story about how you founded your business 5 years ago with your best friend, Stacy, who you met your freshman year in college. The truth is, no one really cares about that story until you answer their questions. People are coming to your website and they are thinking about themselves. They are not necessarily thinking about your life story. The second question, is there a simpler way to say this? This leads me into mistake number 3, using overly complicated or vague language. Now, a lot of times when people build websites, they are trying to sound smart and they want to impress people. And what they end up doing is adding in a lot of buzzwords, big words that are really hard for people to understand what exactly they mean. So for my floral business, on my homepage, I could have said, you know, The Floral Guru is a group of floral artisans that design masterpieces with floral expertise using agility, style, and grace. You see how crazy that statement sounds? I'm saying a lot, but at the same time, I'm saying nothing at all. No one knows what that means, and no one is going to take the time to try and figure out why they should care. Instead of saying all of that, what I do say is, we provide florals and decor for those that want more than the average. That is a simple sentence that the average person can understand. And that's what you want on your website. Simple, concise language. Now, once people understand what you do and why they need it, the next thing you have to make sure you have is a direct call to action. You'll see on our website, we have this big pink button that says request a consultation. That is the one action we want people to take after visiting our website. It's important that you not only have a direct call to action, it's important that you repeat this direct call to action over and over and over and over again. You have to make this so obvious for people what you want them to do. You want a 5-year-old to be able to land on your website and to know exactly what you want them to do. Do you want them to book now? Do you want them to order now? Do you want them to schedule a demo? What strong call to action do you want them to take? Now, there are different types of calls to action. You definitely need a direct call to action, but you also should have a transitional call to action. Now, what is a transitional call to action? Sometimes people visit your website because they're interested in your products and your services. but they're not quite ready to commit, especially if it's a big purchase. But you don't want them to just walk away and forget about you. You want to leave them with some valuable information that will help to deepen your relationship with them. So back to my website for an example of this. On our Academy page, the Floral Guru Academy, education arm of my business, people may come and visit this page because they're interested in a class or having a coaching session with me, but they're not quite ready to commit. So instead of just having them walk away and forget all about me, I have a pop-up that says, do you want a free guide, a free marketing guide? 3 mistakes that event designers and planners make, because that's my primary audience. And this is something that I know that a lot of people struggle with. So I put together valuable information, which is going to be tantalizing for them. So they put in their email address, they get this great guide, which is filled with really good information. And I have their email address added to my email list, and I get to communicate with them about relevant offers in hopes of one day, eventually, they are going to have a problem that they need solving related to my world of events. And I'm going to be right there in their inbox offering up a solution. So that's why it's important to have a transitional call to action as well as a direct call to action. Speaking of direct calls to action, if you are finding this video valuable, please hit that like and subscribe button so that you can get more valuable content like this. It also helps me a lot with the algorithm, so it's really a win-win for everybody. Now, moving on to mistake number 6, not using testimonials. What you have to understand is that as human beings, we are always looking for social proof. We feel comforted by the fact of knowing that someone else has purchased what we want to purchase and they've had success with it. And it doesn't matter if the social proof is coming from a friend, family, or a complete stranger. What's most important is that it is there. So you definitely want to have testimonials on your website. Now, you just don't want any type of testimonials. Again, you don't want really long text, things that people are not going to read. You want to keep your testimonials short and punchy. You also want to highlight specific things that you have done for people, specific outcomes. So have you given this person their dream wedding? Did you exceed their expectation? Did you save them money? Did you make them money? Did you save them time? You want there to be specific things in your testimonials, tangible things. You don't want testimonials that just say, love it or helpful. You know, that's not really helpful for a potential customer who's looking to see if your product or service is a good fit for them. The 7th and final tip is around fonts and layout. As much as some of you may like fancy fonts, cursive, all of that jazz, you do not want to sacrifice readability to be fancy. You want people to be able to read what you're talking about on your website. So my advice is to just keep it simple. Have a simple font, simple color palette, and just use that consistently throughout your website. Also, to help people kind of break down the content so that it doesn't look overwhelming, think about your layout and how you can add visuals to break out different sections of your website so that people can take it in chunks. Again, people will get overwhelmed if they see a lot of text and they're not going to read it. If they see short sections with clear headers, they're much more likely to read it. Now, if you're still watching and you want more help with your website, if you want to create a website that is going to drive traffic, drive sales, and grow your business, especially if you are in the event world, hit the link in the description box to work with me to build a better website. Thank you, and I'll see you next week.